Hey guys, Aaron here from BitBranding, and today we're gonna walk you through exactly how to set up a retargeting campaign on Facebook. If this is your first time watching one of our videos, make sure that you hit subscribe and hit the bell on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of our videos that we put out every single week. Let's explain a little bit about a retargeting campaign, because I think this is like one of the eighth wonders of the world. Because when somebody visits your website, that's great, but most of the time when somebody visits your website, they do not convert. This is normal, so don't feel bad. But the increasing ability for you to run advertising back to somebody and say, hey, were you interested in this thing that you left in your cart? Or hey, were you interested in this thing that you were looking at? Or were you interested in this page that you were on? All of those steps or all those things allow you to touch or reach out to your customer another time. What we do know is that it takes on average 7 to 8 times before somebody makes a decision and finally purchases. So allowing you to retarget to those people on Facebook ads is just a really cheap and effective way for you to increase results in your business. All right, so let's go over here to Ads Manager. If you haven't set up your Facebook business page yet, Facebook Business Manager yet, make sure you check out our previous video on that. It's super important and it's super effective for you to be able to do what we're talking about here. Now go over here to Ads Manager and we'll talk a little bit about what you wanna do. So we'd go ahead and start creating a campaign, but first thing that we'd need to do even before we started to create a campaign is go to Audiences. So go to the hamburger menu on the left-hand side, go over to, where are we at here? On mine, it's one of the previous ones, or previously used ones, but under Assets, go ahead and click Audiences. Is you wanna create a custom audience. Now, this is typically, if you're retargeting somebody, it can be off of website traffic. You can do a customer list, which is email list if people signed up, your Instagram business profile, video, which we talked about previously. We actually have a video specifically on how to create a retargeting campaign with videos and people who watch a certain percentage of your video. So check that one out. It's a little bit different. Lead forms on if they engage from that, events if people say that they're interested or not interested, Facebook page or an instant experience. The most common one is probably website, which is why it's over here in the top left. And this is anybody who visits your website, your landing page, your thank you page, any step in your funnel. So go ahead and click website. You want to go and make sure that your client Facebook pixel is set up or your pixel is set up, and you can do that multiple ways. We actually have a video on how to set up your Facebook pixel as well. It takes about 2 to 3 minutes to set it up, put it on your website, but it is needed before you can start creating retargeting campaigns. Now, you can do multiple things here. You can do all website visitors in the past 30 days, and you can actually do, I think the maximum, maximum time here is 180 days that you can retarget people. You can do website visitors, people who have visited specific web pages, or visitors by time spent. One thing to note here is that you should choose something that aligns with whatever your goal is. If you have a ton of people to your website and you want those top 5 or top 25%, you can actually do top 25% of people on the website. That's going to be a pretty good audience. That top 5% of the people on your website, those are going to be super engaged. So those people are spending a lot of time. They're worth more than somebody who spends the top 25%. That being said, if your goal is to reach as many people as possible, that may not be the best option for you just because your number may be lower. We're going to go ahead and do all website visitors in the last 30 days, and you can name this. So we can do client ad account or client website 30 days. You can label it however you'd like. Website traffic 30 days. You're going to create the audience and it will take some time to populate. But then you have an option to create an ad. We will go ahead and do it from here. Normally I do not do that. Whoops. Actually, I'm gonna have to not show you from there. I'll have to go through this way. We're gonna go to Ads Manager. All right, create campaign. We wanna do, so it just really depends on what you wanna do. When you run an ad, make sure that it's the objective that you want people to complete. For example, if you want them to go back to your website, it should be a traffic campaign. If you want them to convert and you have conversions set up, it should be conversions. We're going to just do reach. A reach campaign is perfect for reaching everybody that you want to who visited that page. So your goal is, hey, look, they were interested already. I just want them to see this ad. That's my only goal, is I just want them to look at this ad, to be view, for them to view this ad. If you use something like conversion, Facebook may say, hey, they visited your website and these people are more likely to convert. So we're going to show it to them versus some of the other people. So if there's 100 people and 60 are really going to convert, they may show it to 60 people instead of the full 100. You're going to spend less money that way. You may get higher conversions. Just focus on the objectives that you want. But for me, I know that this play example here is that they've visited one page. They're really not ready to convert yet. So I just want to show them one more ad. So I choose the reach campaign and I'm going to do client, website, visitors, retargeting, reach campain. Go ahead and click continue. And then you want to label this as whatever the ad set is. So the ad set's more like the audience you're going after. So this is website visitors, 30 days. Great. We would want to use the correct page. This is just some made up pages here. I have some Aaron's real estate biz. There we go. Okay, so the next thing you want to do, audiences, custom audience. We have on here client website traffic. Click that. And one thing or one mistake that some people make is that they start going in here and making changes and the audience is so narrow that it never runs. This is super narrow because we haven't, one, A, probably sent traffic to this website in a long time, or B, we just populated it. So make sure you give it some time. It may say unavailable for right now. Just give it some time and it should populate. But don't go in here and start putting the men or women or age or anything like that. And the reason that you don't is that these are people who have been to your site. You don't need to narrow it unless you think that the website traffic isn't good traffic. So go ahead and leave everything how it is. Edit the placements. Usually we'll leave it as all placements except for takeoff audience network. Really just depends. Leave it as a reach campaign. I would do probably 2 impressions every 7 to 10 days, or 3 impressions every 10 days. Really just depends on what your audience is looking at, but you want to just make sure you stay top of mind, but not, what is a better word? You don't want to get ad decay or make them feel like you are just everywhere in the sense that you're annoying them. So make sure that you do it in an effective way too. So kind of do some testing with how often or the frequency that they see your ads. Go ahead and click continue here. And then you would want to label this ad as something that you've had before. So for example, we have this. I'm going to change the image to just a random image here. One thing about the image that you should note is that it should be related to where you're sending people back to. There's a disconnect in the ad and the landing page. If there is a disconnect between the two of them, more than likely people are going to bounce because they're unsure of why they're actually going there. So make sure that if this is the type of image you're showing, that the landing page that they're going back to or the website they're going back to is similar. So this is, I'm going to label this as Aaron and Christian. There we go. And then you could label the text, put the text in there however you'd like. But the important thing is you just want to review it and then you can confirm. Last thing to check though is to make sure that that pixel is on. You'll see that green dot, and that's making sure that you track everything, tracking all the visitors so that you get the right data. Now, the most important thing here is to make sure that you just continuously look at the updates for this. I would say every 2 to 3 days to make sure that the right stats are in place and that you're running the ads to the right people. If you're not getting results, try a different campaign, try a different traffic, but just keep testing here and make sure that this works. And really, it's just it's a matter of trial and error, or keep testing what works and then what does work, keep making sure to double down on that. But retargeting is very important for your business and is very inexpensive, so you shouldn't be spending, you know, if you get 1,000 people to your website, it's not going to cost you hundreds of dollars to reach those people again. It should be very inexpensive for you to do that. So if you guys have any questions, any more questions about retargeting, maybe specifics or walking through Ads Manager, make sure to leave a comment below and let us know that you'd like to see that. And again, if you got some value out of this video, make sure that you hit that like button, make sure you hit subscribe, and then you hit that bell so you don't miss out on any of the content that we put out every single week. Have a great week.